24 hours after stepping down as coach of the West Coast Eagles, Don Worsfold remains tight-lipped. But his former players weren't so quiet, thanking him for his career. Tim Hipsley reports.
Day one, life away from the Eagles.
Can we get a quick chat?
John Worsfold laying low after stepping down as coach yesterday, ending a 24-year relationship with the club. 209 games as a player, 281 as a coach, and a total of three premierships. While Worsfold preferred not to talk, his former players were glowing in his praises.
Nick, have you spoken to John?
Yeah, I have, yeah.
What did he have to say?
Oh, not many words, just we all kind of thanked him for the time we spent with him, and we're appreciative of it as well.
The playing group getting together for lunch today.
Big day for the footy club yesterday. Woosh, I can't speak highly enough.
Never did I think I needed a new coach. He was always refreshing.
Attention now turns to who his replacement will be. Peter Sumich was once Worsfold's right-hand man and is now an assistant at the Fremantle Dockers. From inside the Eagles' nest, assistant Scott Burns is the most likely, while sacked Brisbane boss Michael Voss can't be ruled out.
We'll get the best person for the job. There's lots of names being thrown around.
One name that was floated months ago was Paul Roos. He's put any rumours to bed, signing a two-year deal at the Melbourne Demons.
So I know it's going to be a very, very difficult job, but I'm very excited about being here.
A new era for the Eagles next year and beyond, with the club announcing they'll build a new $50 million headquarters and elite training base at Lathlain Park.
We owe it to our players and our members to have facilities that are state-of-the-art.
It's expected to be ready by 2017. Tim Hipsley, 10 News.